Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Keeneland Racecourse here on Saturday. It is April the 13th, 2019. It's a Lexington day from Keeneland, and I'm going to look at all the stakes races on the program. But before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for race courses around the world. Also, check out my Arkansas Derby preview video. That's going to be a great card of racing from Oaklawn today. And also, join me starting Tuesday for the Craven meeting from Newmarket in the UK. That's the first big, really good meeting for the flat in England this year, and you're going to see some very good horses run on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday at Newmarket. Join me here on YouTube for some previews for those races. But today's card from Keeneland's very good. I'm going to look at all the stakes races 7 through 10. It's all conveniently packed into an all-stakes pick 4, which I'll give you a ticket for, and I think it's very hittable, so let's get on to it. I think you're going to make some money with these races. So 7 through 10 we're going to look at. Let's get to the 10th race from Keeneland, which is the Ben Alley Stakes. It's a Grade 3 event going for a purse of $200,000, race for 4-year-olds and upwards. Field of 11 horses are going to post the distance of ground of 1,800 meters, or the distance of ground of 1 1/8 on the Keeneland main track. 1,800 meters, 1 1/8. And I show the diagram, and just give me that little extra second to look down at my notes, just bear with me. Top selection here in the Ben Alley, I'm going to go to the number 7 horse, Noble Commander. I'm going to go 7-6-4-8 in the superfecta, 7-6-4-8 super. To the multi-race now, I'm going to go 4 deep here, because I'm going to single later on in the day, but I'm going to go 7, I'm going to use all the horses basically in my superfecta here. So 7-6-4-8 in the pick 4, but the time selection is 7 horse Noble Commander, 4-year-old colt by Forestry. Phil D'Amato trains for Laurent Giroux, picks up the mount. The horse's most recent out came 29th of December at the fairgrounds, 1 mile on the slop off the turf in the Woodchopper Stakes. He won by 1 3/4 lengths there. He sat on the front and all throughout, he got the whip and he just excelled. It was a very easy race for this horse there. Before that, on the 16th of November at Churchill, mile 16th optional 100 claimer, he finished 7th by 17 1/4 lengths. He went to the front and early on, but then he just kind of hit the wall. The winner, Lone Rock, just ran that better race, and he won next stat out. It wasn't the day to win. And then optional 100 claimer here at Keeneland, 6.5 October the 10th, first off the break. The horse finished 9th by 8 1/4 lengths there. He didn't break all that well, and he lost all chances there. He ran in the Federico Tessio about a year ago at Laurel going 1 1/8, where he finished 3rd by 2 lengths. He ran a good first mile 16th, but then he just kind of got caught in the final few strides of the race, but he ran his heart out here. This track at Keeneland is this spring so far is playing towards speed. If he could break well and go to the front end, I think he could be very, he could possibly get away with it. So I'll use him here as a top selection at 15-1. He is stepping up in class, but he is definitely good enough to win. So to recap my selections for the 7th from Keeneland, it's a Grade 3 Ben Alley Stakes. I'll go with the 7-horse Noble Commander. I'm going to go 7-6-4-8 in the superfecta, and like I said, I'll go 7-6-4-8 in the pick 4. To race number 8 now from Keeneland, it is the Giants Causeway Stakes. It's going for a purse of $100,000 for races for fillies and mares, 3-year-olds and upwards. Field of 11 horses are tackling, or dashing, shall we say, the distance of ground of 1,100 meters, or the distance of ground of 5.5 furlongs on the Keeneland lawn, the turf course. 1,100, 5.5. My top selection here, I'm going to go to the number 10 horse, who is... Excessive spending. I'm gonna go 10-4-8-6 in the superfecta. 10-4-8-6 super. To the multi race, I'm gonna go 10-4-8. 10-4-8 in the pick 4. But the top selection is 10 horse excessive spending. 5-year-old mare by Shackelford. Chris Hartman trains. Julian Leperu picks up the mount. The horse's most recent out came the 5th of March at the fairgrounds. 5.5 about on the turf course in the Mardi Gras Stakes. And the horse finished 3rd by 3/4 length. Had a horrible beginning. If this horse broke better, probably would have won, and won very easily, but he didn't break all that well. He had a little bit of a trouble trip, a little traffic, but he was closing and mowing them down late. It was a decent effort at the end, but the break was so horrible. Before that, again at the fairgrounds, 5.5 about on the turf course in the 75,000 overnight stakes a month earlier, he won by half length. Again, he had to check a few times early on, was a little bit wide, but he got the jump done at the end, a very good run, and then in the Panzeretta stakes at the fairgrounds, 5.5 on yielding ground, he finished 3rd by length. He sat back early. He had the lead. It looked like he was going to win, but then he got caught in the final few strides of the race, about the 16th pole. What can you do? But this horse has started here at Keeneland four times in the past and has one victory under his belt here by winning on the 21st of October last year, going 5.5. He's a course and distance winner. He won by 2.25. He stalked, he got the lead, and he took off clear after not the best beginnings. But he's going to have to overcome a wide poster today, but I think he can. He'll like the drier turf course, and he'll see a good pace in front of him to close up with. So at 6-1, I'll take him. This is a very wide open Giants Causeway. Usually it always is. But to recap my selections for the 8th from Keeneland, the Giants Causeway Stakes, I'll take the 10 horse excessive spending. I'm going to go 10-4-8-6 in the superfecta. I'll go 10-4-8 in the pick 4. So now let's get to the featured 9th race from Keeneland, which is the Lexington Stakes. Not to be confused with the race that we used to have here in New York, the Lexington at Belmont, but it's the Lexington Stakes from Keeneland in Lexington, Kentucky. It's a grade 3 race going for a purse $200,000, race for 3-year-olds here. Field of 10 horses going the distance of ground of 1,700 meters, or the distance of ground of 1 mile 1/16 on the main track. 1,700, 1 mile 16th on the main track. Keep in mind, they'll be using the first finish line, so speed really holds up here. With that being said, I'm going to use a very speed-favoring horse, I think, and the single in the multi-race, which will be the 4 horse, another twist of fate. I'm going to go 4-3-5-2 in the superfecta. 4-3-5-2 super. My top selection is the 4 horse, another twist of fate. 3-0 colt by Scat Daddy, who's by Johannesburg, who won the 2001 Breeders' Cup Juvenile here in New York at Belmont very nicely for Mick Cannon and Ian O'Brien. But Blaine Wright trains as one. Javier Castellano picks up the mount for the first time. The horse ran about 3 weeks ago now at Sunland, mile and 8th in the Sunland Park Derby. He finished second by a neck there, and you know, he was a little bit wide after stalking. He had a good turn of foot, but Cutting Humor, just, you know, John Velasquez rode a great race in traffic to get the job done. But this horse, he ran a good race on the front end. He gets the rider switch to Castellano, which a lot of people don't like, but I think the you know, Castellano, he's one he knows his way around Keeneland a lot better, and I just think he'll do a lot better here than Hernandez. It's my personal opinion. Before then, the El Camino Real Derby at Golden Gate on the 8th, February 16th, he won by 7 that day, and on the lead all throughout. He just took off clear. Doesn't get any easier than that. It wasn't the toughest group of horses, but he still won very nicely. And then at Golden Gate, won mile and option 40 claimer. He won by 5, and again, he just won very clear. You know, if he wins today, he's going to the Derby. The only reason they're running him today is because they need points. He's just at the border right now, and you know, if he wins today, he'll definitely go in the Derby. Even if he finishes second, he'll probably, I want to say he'll probably get in, but you know, he like I said, he's running here for the points. He's been training well at Sunland. He had a really fast workout, going 4 furlongs, 46 and 4, the best workout 7. So he's speedy enough to win here. Like I said, speed favoring course. You know, everything points to him. I don't know how he'll do in the Derby if he makes it that far, but like I said, he's live enough to win here. 2-1, I'll take him, and single in the multi race. But to recap my selection for the 9th from Keeneland, it's the grade 3 Lexington. I'm going to go with the 4 horse, another twist of fate. I'm going to go 4-3-5-2 in the superfecta. Let's get to the 10th race from Keeneland, which is the co-feature. It is the Coolmore Jenny Wiley Stakes. It's a grade 1 race going for a purse of $350,000. Races for fillies and mares, 4-year-olds and upwards. We have a field of 8 horses going 1,700 meters, or the distance of ground of 1 mile 1/16 on the main track. 1,700, 1 mile 16th on the turf course, excuse me. Top selection in the Jenny Wiley, I'm going to go to the 8 horse, who is on the moon again. I'm going to go 8-2-4-7 in the superfecta, 8-2-4-7 super. To end off the pick 4, I'm going to go 8-2-4 to end off the pick 4. But the top selection here is the 8 horse on the moon again. 5-0 mare by Cape Cross, Chad Brown trains. John Velasquez picks up the mounts as a top selection. I'm choosing the other Chad Brown here. But this horse's most recent outing came the 9th of March at Tampa, mile the 8th in the Grade 2 Hillsboro. He finished 3rd by 2 lengths there, and he sat back early, was very wide. The closers did well that day. He just missed at the end, but he ran a good race off the break. If he gets a good trip again today with a good pace in front of him, I think he'll really get away with this one. Before that, at Belmont, 7th of October, mile and a quarter in a turf course in the Grade 1 Flower Bowl Invitational, she finished 2nd by 2 lengths there. She sat back early, she closed up well, and then she got caught right at the wire, right before the wire, shall we say. But she ran her heart out there, and then in the Glen Falls at Saratoga, mile 3, 8th, 10th of the first, she finished 4th by 3 and a quarter lengths. The winner, Lady Montador, you know, sat on the front end very easy for actions, went away with it. This horse just didn't have a lot of move. It wasn't the day to win. Also, she didn't break well. And then her North America debut at Saratoga, Melanie from the Melon, she finished third by 1 3/4 lengths. Again, she didn't break all that well, but she had a decent turn of foot. Like I said, I like her second off the break here. A lot of horses are making their first off the break here, but with her second off the break, a fresher horse, has a workout over this course, and I think she'll really get a good run. So at 7-2, I'll use her as a top selection. So to recap my selection for the 10th from Keeneland, it is the Grade 1, 350,000 Jenny Wiley Stakes. I'll go with a 8 horse on the moon again. I'll go 8-2-4-7 in the superfecta. So good luck to all, and please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5. Good luck, everybody.